from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from an anonymous donor from Windsor, Ontario. This Mass is offered for the care and welfare of God's little children. We know that this television Mass brings meaning to the lives of thousands of Canadians across our land and around the world, and they join with me in thanking our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like Margaret Mary Alacrity did in the 17th century, knowing that she was weak, knowing that she needed God's guidance at every breath she took, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Pour out on us, we pray, O Lord, the Spirit which you so remarkably endowed Saint Margaret Mary, so that we may come to know that the love of Christ, which surpasses all understanding, and be utterly filled with your fullness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. I pray that you may not lose heart over my sufferings for you. They are your glory. For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that according to the riches of his glory, God may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to God, who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly, far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church, and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous. Praise be
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, I came to bring fire to the earth, and how I wish it were already kindled. I have a baptism with which to be baptized, and what stress I'm under until it's completed. Do you think that I have come to bring peace to the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, 5 in one household will be divided, 3 against 2 and 2 against 3, and they will be divided, father against son, and son against father, mother against daughter, and daughter against mother, mother-in-law against daughter-in-law, and daughter-in-law against mother-in-law. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I almost was going to say, and this is the good news of the Lord, everyone will continue fighting in the family. But that's, of course, nonsense, and would be a total misinterpretation of Jesus' word. But Jesus, he says, do you think that I have come to bring peace to the earth? No, I tell you, rather division. It's not that Jesus is trying to set up people against one another, but to follow Christ, to be someone of peace, automatically, and who desires peace, automatically is divisive in families. And we don't have to look far in our families. No doubt, if you are praying and trying to be a good Christian, someone will have told you already that you're not with the program, that you're not good. And so there's always division in our families. From a psychological perspective, of course, there's always division between, the famous one, mother against mother and daughter-in-law and so on. But we are called to be people of peace, people who bring people together and solve suffering. As I was praying with this, I came across a little quote of Pope Francis when he was on his way from Kazakhstan, his recent visit to Kazakhstan, which was really not covered too much in the media. But he said, it is difficult to dialogue with those who start a war, but it must be done. When there's division in a family, we have to be people of dialogue and not people who stand there, you just said this and I'm telling you this. But we have to be very careful with our words, how to respond in a loving way, how to be open to someone else's opinion and to appreciate that someone else thinks different than we do, but to rather to be try to be a sign of God's love. And this fits all so nicely in with today's memorial of Mary Margaret Alacoque. Mary Margaret Alacoque, who and her spiritual director, Claude de la Cambrière, who really promoted the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Her name, Margaret Mary, is synonymous with the Sacred Heart of Jesus. To take on that suffering. And in our first reading to Ephesians, St. Paul also talks about suffering, suffering for the people. He does it freely, to be there and suffer, suffer for the good of others. And it's so important. And the Sacred Heart of Jesus is such a beautiful image of that Sacred Heart, the heart of love. And we're all people of love. And those we are struggling with in our families, they're also one of love. They're also people of love. And of course, there's that the crown of thorns, the crown of thorns of suffering. And it's so easy to try to fight it, but to embrace that crown of thorns. We all will suffer. And even when we engage in a battle and we put fuel on the fire, so to speak, it doesn't make it any better. But to be people of peace, and on the say that icon of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, you can have those flames of love, pure love, and that's of course God's love, the infinite love, and it is our task to imitate that infinite love of Jesus, especially in our families, to be there for others, to listen, and not always to react, not always to be offended. And I know some people in my own life, of course, I'm from a family too, and I live in a religious community, and it's so easy to be offended. You just said this, or you did that, and now I'm offended. And then, worst of all, going around and telling everyone, I'm offended. You know what he or he did to me? But this is where the Sacred Heart of Jesus comes in, to calm down, to let it go. And so often, even when people come for spiritual direction, I often hear myself say, let it go, calm down, no good comes from it. Just try to understand where someone else comes from. Listen. And one of the things, of course, in our society too, is, and especially in our secular culture, it is, we are not people who listen anymore what the other person is saying. Often people start to answer already another person before the other person is finished speaking, and right away their opinion or whatever. To calm down and to listen what the other person says, and to ask for an explanation if you don't understand, instead of right away firing back with two guns and just making drama. I call it making drama. And in our society, we are so good about making drama and just getting all kinds of people upset. And so this is our task as Christians, to be that sign of peace, to be that anchor of peace in our families and in the world, and to embrace that suffering. And it is about silent suffering, continuously bringing that pain and the offenses, quote offenses, bringing it to God, and to gently pray with it, and to ask God to intervene in all of that, to give us light to move forward, and to build a better world. World peace starts in the home. It is, of course, on the world level, we need a lot of peace, and we just can go around all the kinds of countries who are longing for peace. But it starts right in our home. If I can make peace in our families, if I can be a sign of peace in our family, then I also can be a sign of peace in the community, in my local church, or local churches often also need so much more peace than there is. Peace in the world, in the greater community. But it starts right by yourselves, right with me. Am I listening to God? Am I listening to God in the silence of my heart? Just like Margaret Mary Alacri did, who got all these visions of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Gently listening and let God heal our hearts. Let God heal our pains, instead of going around and lashing out against those we love. Amen. And so let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in our prayer intention book. We pray that during this time of Thanksgiving, we may be grateful for all our gifts and be willing to share our goods and talents with others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray this month that the Church, courageous in preaching the gospel, may be a community of solidarity, fraternity, and welcome, always living in an atmosphere of synodality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace within our families, that the Sacred Heart may be that sign for Christian unity among family members. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who feel lonely or abandoned may grow in a deeper awareness of the infinite, unconditional love God has for every person. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands of praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin, blessed Margaret Mary, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to the experience on this earth, the gifts you promise in a new world to come. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis or Pope, Thomas or Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom,
power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. Renewed by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord, O God, that by the example of Blessed Margaret Mary Erlikwy, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone, through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donor for the gift of this Mass.